named after the Roman god of war. Our smaller red neighbor has been our focus point for a long time. Humans have never been so far with getting our footsteps on the surface of the red planet. It would be a truly historical moment in human existence. We are curious and always moving forward. We have conquered the moon. And Mars is our next checkpoint in human evolution. But this will not be an easy journey, let alone a nice visit. If we are to stay there, life would be extremely complicated. The mysteries of planet Mars will challenge us like we have never been before. On a global level, we need the smartest people and best technology available to overcome this epic journey. Let's begin by discovering Mars. Moving to Mars would definitely be a shrink in size compared to Earth. It's the second smallest planet in our solar system. The trip to Mars would be about 54 million kilometers. On a bad orbit, this can be as much as 400 million kilometers. On a good day, it would still take about 6 to 8 months to get there. The distance is more than 1.5 times longer than the entire road network of our planet. Once we get closer to Mars, we will notice it's very red. This is because Mars contains a lot of iron oxide. It's the same compound that gives blood its color. We are getting closer and closer. We might even see the two small moons orbiting the planet. They are oddly shaped and very small. They are named Phobos and Deimos. The biggest moon is only 22 kilometers in diameter. Within 20 to 40 million years, the moon Phobos will be torn apart and create a ring around Mars that will stay there for 100 million years. We are ready to land, but we know as of today, from the 40 missions to Mars, only 18 have been successful. There is more than a 50% chance something bad can happen. Once landed, we might be close to the biggest mountain in our solar system. OLYMPUS MONS, a shield volcano that's 21 kilometers high and 600 kilometers in diameter. The height is the same as the entire distance of half a marathon. The diameter of this mountain is close to the state of Arizona. We continue our travel and notice that there is an amazing amount of land around us, even though the planet is much smaller than ours. It visually looks like a never-ending desert. With the lack of water, the total size of land is very close to that of Earth. That doesn't mean that there is not water on the planet. It's just not visible on the surface. This is because it has almost lost all of its atmosphere. The sun wasn't at all friendly against Mars and ripped the planet to pieces, completely destroying the atmosphere with solar winds that contained a continuous stream of particles, mostly protons and electrons. It damaged Mars. This is because Mars has no magnetic field that can pull off this stream from our sun. Earth has been equipped with this magnetic field, and therefore, we didn't have a similar fate Mars encountered. Without life, no water, and barely an atmosphere, staying on Mars without specialized equipment and technology is impossible. It doesn't end there. Mars has the most dramatic dust storms, the largest of our solar system. The dust is very thin and nothing like Earth. It's statically charged and sticks to everything around you. Tiny mistakes on machinery completely destroy them. Also, the challenge of building a habitat that can keep these dust storms out is extremely difficult. But as we know with our universe, it can get even worse. Every 3.5 Earth years on Mars, there is a global dust storm. It will cover the entire planet and even the sunlight coming in. This would have a major impact on our solar panels or other equipment in need of sunlight. Delicate hardware can be destroyed by the thinness of the dust. Even though they are called storms, the speed is relatively slow, about 2 times less than that of a hurricane on Earth. As of today, we are not sure why the global storms only happen every 3.5 years. But what would happen if we take off our gear and take a leap of faith and walk around Mars with our normal everyday clothing? In short, you will die. The average temperature on Mars is minus 45 degrees Celsius. The air pressure is only 1% that of Earth. Your lungs would collapse because you are entering a region close to near vacuum. You would pass out in a few seconds. Let alone the dust could slowly kill you if you get back into your suit. Planet Mars has no mercy and is far from a nice place to live. Masterminds like Elon Musk still want to go there. Not because it's a nice place to live, but because it's in our human DNA to continue forward, and simply because we can. Our technology is rapidly increasing, and our chances of success become more and more likely. Our first interaction with Mars was in 1965 by the spacecraft Mariner 4. It then took us almost 228 days to reach our neighbor. We even took our first photograph on the surface in 1976 by the spacecraft Viking 1. In 2003, we found the first evidence of water on the planet. All historical moments. What will come next? Will we set foot on Mars? Or will we fail and should we look somewhere else? Thank you for watching. We have given you a small look into this subject. We might have missed something. We might have gotten something wrong. Let us know what your thoughts are. We hope you stay around for another episode. Only if you like this video, please subscribe to see more episodes.